I welcome you all with my love and respects. I'll continue on the yesterday's sutra. There are some important points, sacred secrets. You need to understand. This is 154th sutra, 3rd chapter, 48th verse. Grahana, grahana, swarupa, asmita, anvaya, artavatva, samyamat, indriya jayaha. Yesterday I spoke on the two keywords of the sutra, grahana and swarupa. Today I'll talk on the asmita and artavatva. The word asmita means literally experience of I amness. See, this experience of I amness, if this is connecting with the senses, with awareness, then you are living life. Means you are straight away living enlightenment. But if this I amness and the connection to the senses are unconscious, then any amount of energy I give, even if you awaken your whole kundalini, you will have a separate exhaust pipe near your head and that kundalini will go away. End of the whole kundalini awakening session, you may have at the most little body pain because you jumped. That I amness becoming conscious, that I amness is making fun. Usually when the kundalini is awakened, it doesn't leave the system that easily unless you are really adamant that you don't want that energy inside your body and you are telling it, get out, it's too much, I can't be that intelligent. The I amness connecting with the senses, see, the I amness connects with the senses unconsciously. When you boil in anger, violence, and take decisions out of anger and violence, please understand, the I amness does not act or supports any action on its own. Please understand. Try to see this discourse once more after I complete, because you need to understand every statement, you should not miss it. These are all the high, subtle philosophy. The I amness connects with your senses with awareness when you are in restful awareness. Please understand this. I amness is a pure conscious shaft, asmita. Senses are the matter. If the bridge between the I amness and senses are anger and violence, the function will be unconscious. If that bridge is the restful awareness, the function will be conscious. When the function is conscious, you will have the extraordinary powers, that's all, nothing else. This is the essence. Again, everything boils down to unclutching. The more and more and more restful awareness living is practiced, the more and more higher experiences are gained. I wanted all the inner awakening participants to know, in this whole 21 days of program, literally I am making you live these great samyamas. That is the reason you experience the extraordinary powers and the experiences like a levitation or divine darshan, vision or teleportation, whatever. Once your biomemory catches this experience, after that you don't need to practice anything. At the most, you may need to practice kind of a restful awareness or unclutching whenever you want, whenever you can. But once the bridge between the I amness and the sense is restful awareness, actually in these 21 days, that's what I'm making it in you. I am just breaking the bridge which you built in wood, the anger and violence, and making it as a beautiful concrete bridge with restful awareness so that it will not shake. So that the I amness can operate with the senses, with more sensitivity and awareness. Yesterday all of you understood. Unclutching before initiation, after initiation. Before initiation you struggled for hours, nothing was happening. Just one touch. After that I saw the whole hall is in silence. I thought, oh God. Not even little bit of restlessness, as if little Buddhas. The whole hall was so beautiful to see 100 little Buddhas sitting. Just one initiation, all these fellows become like little Buddhas. All I did is removed that restlessness, that anger-based bridge. Somehow, all you guys feel, inside heart of the heart, you know you are God. You wanted that same way to be treated by the world. But you need to know, you need to create the bridge between that I amness which is God and the senses which through which the world is perceiving you. Please understand, you are actually God. But the image you are projecting to the world through the senses is not showing exactly what you are because of that wrong bridge. The I amness is God, which all of you are experiencing. But the world is experiencing you not through that I amness, but through your senses which is presenting you. It is like people who come and see the welcome center and get banged by some of the ashramites who are unconscious, start creating opinion about me. What to do? They are not representing me. All the time, your senses are not directly representing the I amness. Your I amness and senses are not connected with the conscious bridge. The unconscious bridge, that violence, when it becomes bridge, the world perceives you through the senses. The actions you express through the senses. The natural world will not feel you are God. They will not respect you are God. That creates more anger and more violence. Then more unconsciousness, more negative expression, and more violence. This is what has become vicious circle. Breaking that vicious circle, creating a conscious bridge, is what I call initiation. That's what I did yesterday with you all. You guys can't understand why you became so violent. You should not claim you are God. You should just radiate through your senses your godliness. Then simply the world will respect you and respond to you as God. Then naturally you will become more aware. More awareness means more godliness. More godliness means more respect. More respect means more awareness. This becomes a virtuous cycle. Turning your vicious cycle into virtuous cycle is what I call initiation.
Meditation, emphasis, we had a deep connection.